Hi everyone, it's a great honor to be here. Thank you so much for having me. As we introduce today, I'm really excited to talk to you about what we're doing at our company, Home Class. Where our mission and vision is to provide relief for millions of people with debilitating diseases and worms. I know you're thinking, did you say worms? I did say worms, but maybe I should first start. So, in the U.S., when you do a degree program like this, they usually pay for half of my school and then they're going to pay for the last 2 years of equipment. Is that how you do it in the parent too? Yeah. I thought this was really interesting. Really great to go from the bench to the vision side of the last 2 years of my school year, doing things like delivering babies, cohesive babies, surgery, and even having the privilege of spending time with patients that were terminally ill and final days of life that really understand the values of quality. So I would say that the final 2 years of my school really helped me to understand the students that let's be specific as the words. So when we talk about that, you know, what do we know about worms? As it turns out, a lot. So did you know that 4 out of 5 animals in the world are carrier worms? A lot. And this is just a mere small representation of the hundreds of thousands of species that are out there. And this is just so sad. I think that they're from really long time. They started evolving 500 million years ago when the planet was made up of carbohydrates and plant matter. They were here 150 million years ago when T. rex dominated the Earth. And mind you, these worms were found in the fossils of dinosaurs and in the fossils of these ancient plants. And they're still here today, so they outlived these extinct animals. And they were here also when the crop of the sapiens and even the animal now that you come here 50 to 10,000 years ago. And again, more mammoths, not around, but ground worms that were found in the region are still here today. So, how incredible is that? That means that even when the animals have been raped and died, they found a way to adapt. And it's still here today. So I'm going to tell you more about what this is like, serving farmers. So the lab that comes out for a long time, he studies geophysics. So this is here, first here about 20 million years ago, and it's still here today. So he wants to visit to this, what happens in the geology of the planet. And there's some really cool things known about smelling. One of them comes from the research pheromone system. They use these pheromones. It's a huge pheromone, not made by any other pheromone, with a carbon tail, with different length of the carbon tail, but different letters they come with. And it helps these worms to do all kinds of things. It helps them to control their mating. And this one is the case with the mating. And also, they all extend lifespan. This is why there's this field of longevity in geologists and will help come to a hibernation state for the extended lifespan. So, I kept going back to, wait a minute, there's species of worms that are still around. And anyone ever asked, can they correlate and evolve in all of these worms? Maybe scientists have a lot to say that. What can you say? Every single one. But how many worms? Because when am I going to get all these worms? I mean, there's so many out there. There's worms that, at least that right here, the Pisteanthus, is actually just there. Why is it just the other end of the scale? So cool. Plant parasitic nematodes, plant fungus
strong enough to hold her beautiful, pristine roots from plants that grow this parasitic worm. And it's fantastic. It's so fun. So this is my favorite. So, you know, originally, I actually thought this was going to be a piece of stuff. There's 20 different chapters, 20 different species, 20 different parallels. And then we found that all using all the things we know that they can, including modified fungus, including modified other worms, including changing the plant immune system. The training is to learn. So now just wrap your head around that up to the worms. So you can hear the first person who's going to hear the same language. And they're probably adapting it to different environments and changing the ecology around them. What is actually the thing that's causing worms to modify the microbes? This is what happens when you don't get that word to modify the microbes. And just for a second, when you want one, you want a worm, you want it to have your host to grow. You want to see the things of beneficial microbes. And that's how important it is. If you use the only, and the fact that the matter is, you know that what is going to do that. And you can coincidence that areas of the world that have now times seem to be almost usually exclusive from areas that have sports and sports. The answer is that it's not a coincidence. But it's actually definitely a good return of one that keeps showing that worms can look really human. You can walk obesity. This is a study where these two entities ingested the same amount of the medicine that they could have come out ingested. And one of the worms had, you know, less weight on the worms, had 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 less this evidence. Plus, I have a list of three scientists and people who I know how to do labs and teachers from nerds. You extrapolate them. Plus, now I'm going to be able to do this by a people who are really making a huge impact on human health. Plus, my scientific clinic will really have a patient really I just wanted to say that there's so many people If you want, Thank you so much.